Welcome! In this video, I will break down in detail and show you how Penta dominated Playing Ducks on their defensive hold of custom inspection and supply room on border, and they won that round without losing a single of their own players. First, I will show you the round as it happens, and after that, I will go back and break down every play and explain their defensive setup, why it worked, and how you can use it to win more matches. If you don't already subscribe, please hit subscribe here below, and with that, let's watch the round.
Commonly defended on border, it's pretty much shunned as the worst site on the map, I would say. People even often preferring to defend Tellers. However, border did come out before Mira did, and now the Mira play coming from Penta might be exactly what they need to make this a winning formula. We'll see how they choose to defend it. Looks like they're going to invest very heavily in CCTV. They've opened up both of the drop downs. They're going to use that east wall of CCTV Mira window. As you can see, Chaos probably going to be setting that up pretty soon here.
I mean, you've talked about it before, how once the defense has decided they want to keep control of CCTV, it is very difficult, and it's a very expensive push for the attacker to try to take control of.
Right.
So if you can keep control of the top floor, you can keep control of the bottom floor.
Right, and it does mostly mount to the mirror window placement that will be likely coming out here in just a second. Yeah, there it is, onto that east wall of CCTV. That gives you control over the south door or two from the balcony, that one that you can see Lackey and Renewals here stacking up on. It gives you control over that. It gives you control over the main hallway upstairs, both junctions, or both directions. And it also really forces the attackers, the only way to really get into CCTV is via the west lobby, or west balcony, which you can see Junis prone right now, looking towards the west lobby from Armory. He's going to be the one who's going to run out if any of the attackers pressure onto west balcony, excuse me. And the thing is that inherently then, CCTV has all their bases covered, and it's really difficult to pressure it as an attacking team.
And you can see Goga's over here. He's got the heartbeat sensor detecting who's out on this west balcony to allow units to rush out forward. Mm-hmm. Now, you will spot one repelled here. That's going to be Meepy. Doesn't necessarily know which operator this is or who in particular. But from this angle that we have Goga at, he's able to get a lot of intel.
Yeah, you can see the Ironsides coming out here for Junis onto the Bandit. That is, a lot of people would say, oh, why is he playing Ironsides? Well, it's because Bandit Ironsides are widely considered by professional players to be the best Ironsides in the game. They're really quite easy to work with. It's almost like using a holographic, but you don't have the casing of the hollow itself.
Now we are going to have Goga rush on out and tag Snookin, it looks as though. Might have been actually underneath. No, he had a hole in the floor. He was able to get that kill there,
yeah.
And that's a very good pixel peek to get rid of the Thermite.
There's a really great angle where Goga is playing specifically. Ooh, Goga picks off another one secretly down now. That's that same exact angle you can see here on the floor that has direct line of sight onto the bottom of the window as you vault in. Chaos, meanwhile, is going to take out Meepy at 2 versus 5 now.
Renewal is going to get a couple shots into his side, and we've got all of the members of Playing Ducks just dying with...
Alright, let's have a look how Penta set this up. So, they have 4 defenders upstairs. They have Paul sitting here. This orange lines is where they open the floor so they can keep an eye below. See, he had a castle barricade behind him. They have a shield here for extra cover. They also played, this was Mira. Mira is not available in the whiteboard, that's why it's a recruit icon, but that was Mira, and this was her window. Keep an eye on down the hallway. They had some barbed wire here. Then they had a very good combination here. They had Bandit here. He had a small hole in the wall and the door open, so he can peek there from 2 angles. So he was working with Pulse. Pulse was scanning here, reporting into Bandit, who then can shoot them when he gets the call. Also, if needed, Pulse can give him a crossfire if they decide to go for Bandit. So very good setup here with people on both sides, making it very hard for the attacks to come in, especially since this is Pulse, who know every movement they make. And with Mira here, she can totally deny the hallway here. She have full access here, and with this shield, it's hard for them to push in here since they can take them from 2 angles here. Then you have Castle back here, who protected Bandit essentially. And he also rotated down to play the downstairs on the objective with around 1 minute 15 seconds left. But from the beginning, before they knew that the attackers gave up on the top floor, he played up here and supported Bandit so he can focus on the balcony without worrying about his back. If you look at the objective floor, Smoke was the only one playing here. He was playing pretty freely down here. But their main setup here was the reinforced detention. They reinforced here with the this was a Mira, so they can keep an eye so no one can breach here. Castle barricade, and they have opened up holes here in, at the top of the wall. So, for example, if they decide to jump through this window into the site here, smoke cannon from inside here just throw smoke grenades over the top, so they can't see him, but he can land the smoke grenades down here and smoke them out at the window. So, very smart holes to open up here. Then, the holes that they have opened from the top floor, they kept an eye on this door, so they couldn't come through because of a hole in the ceiling here, so they can be shot through when they come here. Same thing here, at the tension, holes here, and holes here. Keep an eye on this window. And this was the holes through the floor was the thing that won them the round, because Pulse was sitting here, and he just picked them apart. As soon as they jumped in through the window, he just shot them. They couldn't see him, they couldn't get the angle on him. So, this is where they won the round. They were so good holding upstairs, so they forced them to go downstairs, but they couldn't really get it done before, because they haven't cleared here. And with all these murder holes in the floor, it was very hard for them to take the objective. This round was nothing short of a statement from Penta. And you can tell that Playing Ducks, they didn't expect them to pick customs. They look confused, they're starting to go upstairs. They decided to not take upstairs since it was so heavily guarded. Decided to just basically walk into the site, jump through the window. And they just got picked apart one by one. I just love the strat that Penta took the site that is considered to be the hardest. And they just turned it around and did it in a new way with Mira and with four players upstairs. And it worked so nice. Not a single of the Penta players was killed this round. The Bandit and Pulse combo towards the balcony and Mir watching the hallway was extremely powerful in the way of holding the top floor. And when you combine that with all the holes they had in the floor, it was very hard for Playing Ducks. I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and I will be back with more Rainbow Six Siege guides and tips just like this one. So don't forget to hit subscribe here below, and I will see you next time.